spirit remain consistent. You know, guys are just having fun playing together, and it's good. You know, I always go back to the D-Lo quote of, wait till we get a full offseason training camp together, and you can see that. You can see that early maturation and early cohesiveness building. They were out there, you know, we wanted to wait a couple days and just let them compete up and down full court before we started getting intricate into the sideline out of bounds, baseline out of bounds. But today they were doing it on their own. So it just, again, like I say, you have that corporate knowledge that's been established, and guys are really high-level thinkers on the court. You get through different things with more speed, with more swiftness, and so it gave us a chance to teach it on the fly. So again, the competitive spirit continues with the people.
I'm
going
to
buy you another one.
Oh, man.
But no, it was good. Day two was great.
There was so much talk coming in about Rui, and you were even excited about his offseason and workouts, et cetera. But now to see it coming to your point within the realm of what you guys are trying to establish, accomplish, what's standing out with him?
Just his, the way he's trying to diversify himself. The way he's locked in defensively, he really wants to go to a different level. He verbally told me that he wants to go to a different level defensively. We saw how he progressed from the time we acquired him all the way through the end of the regular season, through the playoffs, and then how everyone else is kind of in tune with that. Well, no kind of, they're really locked in on it, and how they're trying to do everything they can to help their teammates and make themselves more effective. And by that I mean, it's not just scoring the ball when you got the ball. I mean, just the running habits, the screening, the rolling, the cutting, the offensive rebounding, support, talking, all the chatter on the defensive side of the ball. So everybody's on the same page, locked in, man, trying to learn and grow and embrace and execute.
Kevin, throughout all the ups and downs last season, you were really calm, really cool, really collected, and things ended up going just as you said they were.
Just patience, like patience. We live in a microwave society. We want everything yesterday. The best meals are slowly cooked, you know. If you get caught up in what's in the peripheral and not your sole focus and tunnel vision almost, and you don't have a great support system like I had last year and still have with Jeannie and Rob, I think, you know, you can find yourself losing your way. But I just knew what the job entailed and what the year one mission was, and that was to do all of the heavy lifting again to get us back to being the organization that everyone knows and loves and competing at a high level. And once we got our pieces right, that we would hit the ground running and things would turn for the better. And so just understanding what you have to do in the short term, which will in turn affect the long term, and knowing that plan is solid. Been through that plan in other places with other franchises, and none of them were called the Los Angeles Lakers. So just being able to do that here and knowing the city of LA, the fans we have, the type of organization this is and what it represents, it's not hard to get help from other places that's available, high level help in terms of players. So we just had to keep our plan solid, stick to it, and not panic, just be patient.
Darvin, did at the end of when LeBron came back from the foot injury last year, like, we could all kind of see him sort of laboring through things. We didn't have the same burst that he had maybe in December, you know, when he went on that big scoring run. Does that burst look back to you when you see him? And have you seen him make explosive type plays? Is he controlling himself?
Oh, yeah. Without question. And, you know, he's able to pick his spots now. You know, he's an elder, wise man on the court and as well as off the court. And he's very calculated in the way he chooses his spots to do that and to show that. Now he has a ton of help. And you know, it's only going to make him and allow him to play and have that burst for longer stretches during games, during the season. So now when we get to our destination, you know, he'll be clicking on all cylinders. But no, he's 100% healthy. He looks fine. He looks like a third or fourth year LeBron.
For a player of this caliber, deferring isn't the right word. That's getting the ball to LeBron will always be a good option for guys. But he's, you know, he's talked about wanting to help in different situations at the time, but it's always still felt like, still LeBron. Do you think seeing him seeing what I'm other guys were able to do last year and saw how he went with that. That kind of helped him buy into that sort of more picking the spots type of a role.
Yeah, he's going to quarterback. He's going to help us decipher what we need to decipher in terms of strategy and how we attack our opponents. And the same as we did last year. But this year, you know, we just saw Gabe Vincent in the day of scrimmage with a huge 3-pointer, put his team up one, and ultimately win the scrimmage. So AD making big plays, D'Lo making big shots, like Austin. You know, he has help, really. Like Christian Wood, like, it's helped everywhere. Guys have made big shots, game-winning shots, in big moments. And so, just based on that fact, you know, it's he'll be able to pick his spots when he needs to be aggressive, and we want him to be aggressive. But also, again, he's a selfless, the probably most selfless elite superstar I've ever seen. And he's just going to make the right play. He got dogged for it early in his career, saying he was afraid of them all. Nothing could be farther from the truth. But he just takes his time, and he makes the right basketball play. And now these guys that's been assembled to go around the NAD are only going to make that even more.
How many preseason games do you
think LeBron play? As soon as we decide, I'll let you know,
baby. As soon?
Yeah, as soon as it's coming. Both of you as soon as possible.
LeBron, obviously last year was the all-time scoring record in the NBA.
Guy from Australia, right? Brazil. Okay. I was close.
Geographically close.
Yeah, we're all running out of ways to describe.
Long time.
We're running out of ways to describe all the things he's accomplished.
Nowhere near each other. We keep going.
If he adds that, right? If he adds that on top of all the other things. Especially because of the way basketball is improbable.
I think it's significant to everyone around the world, all the basketball fans and whatnot around the world. But LeBron, I mean, he just wants to enjoy the moment. You know, he's at the back. He's on the backside of his career, and who knows how many more years he'll be able to do this or get to do this or even want to do it. So I just think for him, it's another feather in his cap, one of many that already exist there. And as long as he's having fun and enjoying the game, and he feels like he has a chance to win at the highest level, which we feel like we absolutely do as long as we put in the work. But that type of thing doesn't phase him. You know, I heard him over say that, you know, he doesn't realize these records until they're actually being mentioned to him or getting close to him. So he's constantly thinking about how he can best serve his team, how he can best help his teammates and coaches. Go from there, just maximizing each day and enjoying each moment we get to be out here together.
Jordan, Jalen was name checked by D'Lo and Austin yesterday. Yep. Someone who stood out in the scrimmage. What did he show you? What did he surprise you?
I mean, just his stability at the position. I got on him a little bit yesterday. Jalen was really soft spoken. I said, kid, you're going to be a 15-year point guard in this league. Skill set you have, where you're going to get better, how young you are. You got to start screaming. You got to just scream when you're in the house by yourself. Just start yelling and screaming for no reason. Because you're going to have to be the one to keep your teammates organized. And they got to always understand what we're doing out there. Whatever possession it is, in every possession. And not his head agreed, but he just went out there and played. He plays with a lot of moxie. He plays, again, like I mentioned, he plays with stability. You know, you can't speed him up. You can't slow him down. He's strong. He's a fierce competitor in a silent way. So you're not just going to do whatever you want to do with him. He's going to guard the hell out of the ball, guard off the ball, try to rebound. He plays a powerful, powerful game at that position individually. And so, he was phenomenal yesterday. He was actually, I don't think anyone would disagree if I called him the MVP at day one. He was very solid. We're really, really excited about him.
It's early, but do you guys have a G League/NBA plan for him?
Yeah. Totally.
Montreal.
I'll tell you the next time we go to lunch.
Thanks, coach.
Thank you.
Yeah. And the squad as a whole.
It's been great. The atmosphere, the energy. We've been getting after it and, you know, getting to know each other. So, yeah, it's been a good environment the first couple of days.
Obviously, so much talk about the chemistry, the continuity, et cetera, carry over from last season. How do you see that benefiting the team, even though early?
Like you said, it definitely carried over from last year. You know, most of our guys already know our system, so, and some of these guys came from similar systems, so just being able to have a lot of our vets and guys that know the system, being able to teach them and, you know, make that transition for them a little easier. But like I said, the first couple of days, everybody's been attentive and catching on quick, and, you know, it's been great.
Yeah, LeBron was dealing with foot injury for most of the time. You guys were teammates tonight. Have you seen a different level of burst and pop from him?
Nah, he's been looking good. Just, you know, energy level, the activity, him changing into the floor. Like, he definitely looks like he has a little more bounce and pep to his step. So, you know, we're glad to have him back 100%. And, you know, like I said, he's still moving like a freight train. And so, yeah, it looks good.
Did you see any ways where the foot was laboring for him last year during the playoff run? Did you see in between games or anything like that?
No, I just knew, you know, him being a professional, he stayed on top of it. You know, obviously during the game, you couldn't really tell the practices, but he made sure he got the proper treatment and was ready and prepared for the next game. So, like I said, that's one of those nagging injuries that, like, you know, it's painful, but you can play with and play through. So, and, you know, he did that. So we just seen him, you know, day in and day out, just preparing and getting treatment and just making sure he's ready for the next game. So, yeah.
I know there's been a lot of speculation about the fit of the starting spot. We saw you getting reps out there when the starting group. Have you had any conversations with RVD about the role and whether that's going to be the starter?
No, we have not. Right now, I'm just going out, just playing hard, getting ready, trying to get to know our teammates and, you know, play together. And, you know, we let the coaches handle all that. Everybody's just out here competing. We let the coaches play that out.
Jalen was mentioned this summer. We just had a big couple first days at camp. What have you seen from him on the floor? Jalen. He's been mentioned this summer. We had a big first couple days at camp. Just what have you seen from him the last couple of practices?
Him just accepting the challenge. You know, he's obviously wasn't scared of the moment, just being able to come out aggressive. You know, he's picking up playing 4-4, he's playing defense, he's making the right plays. And, you know, to be a young player to come out and just be aggressive, you know, says a lot about him. You know, especially in this atmosphere, his first training camp, he's definitely held his own and he's been playing well. I think just our versatility. Like, we can, you know, play many different ways, play small, play big, and we got a lot of wing guys, long guys that can, you know, switch, you know, play in the passing lane, you know, switch on the bigs. And I think, you know, by me and AD setting that tone defensively, you know, guys like even, you know, Bron, D'Lo, AR, they've just learning to be in the right position, you know. So, like I said, we have a super long team as opposed to last year. So being able to utilize that and using our versatility, you know, is going to pay some dividends.
Is there somebody defensively who tried to model your game after?
I mean, for me, I feel like each team I've been on has been different. You know, I've been had to play like the Draymond role defensively. I had to play like the, you know, the wing defender, like Scotty. So it all depends on. Here I'm more of a wing defender. My previous team, I was kind of more of a not interior, but, you know, I wasn't really on point of attack. So it's hard to say who I really look at, but I look at, you know, pretty much everybody. You know, Draymond, to Brian and Scotty, even down to Ariza and Meta. You know, those guys being wing defenders here. So it's a lot of guys I kind of, you know, take pieces from.
Jared, what's the challenge of that? Where sometimes you're guarding the point of attack, as you said, it might be a point guard, another night it might be a wing. How does that impact you on the other end and matchups? What's the way you mentally do all that?
I mean, the only impact is that most times when I'm point of attack, we probably cross match, you know, so just being able to recognize that, switching ends of the floor, that's probably the only thing Like I said, with our versatility this year, sometimes I'll be point of attack, sometimes I'll be the weak side, I'll be the interior defender. We got a lot of guys that can just move around the floor on both ends, so yeah.
So the coaches then had this offseason knowing what you could do in that sense. Have you talked to them about that being part of what allows the versatility, that you can be on the floor and, you know, switch between the guards and the big players?
Yeah, for sure. Me being versatile, being able to, you know, guard multiple positions and, you know, even having other guys like Torrey and Prince, being able to provide that spark as well from a versatility standpoint. Even using, like, you know, Christian and Jackson Hayes, those guys are, you know, can switch and guard the perimeter, guard the space as well. It's along with AD. So we have, like I said, we got a lot of guys that can guard the space. And you know, our objective is to strengthen the floor with our length. And, yeah.
I know on the offensive end, coach said that he's changing the spacing around a little bit. Have you seen that change with the spacing? And how do you like it with, like, guys like, you know, Gabe Benson and others that can really
Man, we've been switching it up sometimes four out, one in, five out. You know, we have a lot of guys that can dribble, shoot, pass, cut. And so just kind of having a more free-flowing offense, I think we've been, you know, initiating that more. And just also, you know, we're definitely elite in the pick and roll, but, you know, mixing in some chases and off-ball action, I think that'll help kind of get, you know, everybody involved. So it's been going well.
I think it's been good. Learning a lot, obviously, with the guys really being out there. But overall, it's been good. Just been learning, taking it one day at a time.
Coach called you the MVP of day one. A lot of guys talking about just what you've shown over the first couple of days. What's that a reflection of? What was the emphasis for you personally coming in?
Definitely just the work I've been putting in ever since summer league. Pretty much been here the whole summer, so and then with the coaches putting in a lot of work. So the main thing I think playing at this level is just having confidence. So that's what I tried to. Obviously, the nerves were definitely high, definitely a little nervous. But at the end of the day, it's basketball. So when I got out there, I just tried to play my game, be aggressive, and, you know, be myself.
Darvin really complimented the way you played and carried yourself. But he told us he wants you to do more. Is that, as a rookie, and you're sharing the court with some future Hall of Famers, is that like a process you have to kind of talk yourself into, to really to kind of, you know, get yourself in the right frame of mind to be a vocal player when it's natural to play a veteran?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's really the main thing I'm focusing on. Like you said, playing with older guys. Just trying to find that voice. And, I mean, I think naturally off the court, I'm a natural quiet guy, but obviously on the court, you got to be vocal, especially at the point guard position. So definitely trying to find that, get more assertive. That comes with time, and obviously I gotta find my way and, you know, earn that right.
Well, what's been the biggest adjustment playing with some of these guys?
Honestly, if I'm like probably just being more vocal, commanding more. Overall, I mean, on the court, obviously the speed is different and everything, but I feel like I'm adjusting well, still learning the NBA game, but I'll get better with everything as, you know, time goes on.
How do you work on becoming more vocal? Darvin told us that he literally told you to scream by yourself at home. Is that like actually something guys do? Like, what do you do to try to hone that part of your life?
Nah, he's probably joking on that part, but I mean, really just talking. Talking, you know, commanding more, obviously screaming out the plays, being a point guard, just seeing things out there, putting guys in the right spot. You don't gotta be, everybody's a different league, but you don't gotta be so rah-rah. You can pull guys aside, do certain things, but to answer your question, just talking.
There was a moment where you were able to shoot on the side. There's been some vets that you've been talking to and really learning from these last 2 days.
I mean, really, all the vets, like all the vets have been cool, all the vets have been there to, you know, guide, share advice and whatnot, but a lot of times I'm working out with games, so he's definitely been somebody who's been great, been showing me the way, just the way he approaches the game. Like, he's really a pro, obviously, just the way he carries himself, it's been cool for me.
What's it been like going up against Steve?
It's been great, just because of the way he plays the game, he understands the game really well, his pace. He's been another great vet. He's been pulling me aside, telling me what he's doing. Anytime I'm hitting shots or I'm being aggressive, he's always telling me, like, keep going, your job, man. Keep going. So, I mean, it's been great.
What do you feel like different spacing-wise? You know, playing at Indy, I know you played in summer league, but with these guys out here spacing-wise, do you feel like that's a big difference from summer league and from college, for sure?
Yeah, 100% the space is different. I mean, college, it was way different. It was definitely more congested. So in an NBA game, you know, you got guys who can obviously shoot the ball. So, I mean, it's been great. I'm still obviously, you know, trying to find my way, still learning every day. But spacing's a lot more better, definitely more room to work. So,
And then having seconds to operate, like having 0.1 seconds, 5 seconds to operate. Has that been something like the ball movement? Been a little adjustment for you too as well?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's something that the coach has been harping on since summer league, really. Especially with the team we have now. Like, if I am on the court and I get the ball, I'm not going to have time to try to break somebody down. Just get the ball and make a quick decision. So, that's something I think I've been getting better at. And, you know, it also comes with time.
What are some takeaways playing with, now that you've played with LeBron scrimmage for a couple days, what takeaways about playing with him specifically?
The main thing, obviously, he's a talented player, one of the best players that ever played the game, but really just the way he sees the game and how he's always dissecting and breaking everything down. So, and that goes along with all the players who've been there. Like, you can tell just the experience they have and the way they're able to see things. And even playing against them, you can tell that, you know, they know the spots, they know the play breaks down to get to, you know, next action. So, really just overall their understanding of the game and IQ.
You mentioned Gabe and Dino. Have been able to play alongside them at any point near the scrimmages?
Yeah, I mean, today I got to play with Gabe. Even prior workouts in the past when we competed, I got to play against him and play with him. So, I mean, it's been cool, been learning a lot. Overall, it's been a great experience.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank
you. Biggest takeaways is I just love the energy we bring in every single day. You know what I mean? Guys are excited to be here. It's not like a weird, too excited kind of vibe. You know what I mean? It's just more of an excitement and eagerness to get out there and compete and play and get to know one another.
For you personally, Coach, just talked about you hitting a three, put your team up, ultimately winning the scrimmage. How have you seen yourself fit in?
I mean, I've been able just to be myself, which I think is extremely valuable. It's sometimes rare in this league, so guys have embraced me and allowed me to play my game and compete at the level I compete at and talk. And everyone's kind of been receptive and also giving me knowledge as well. So it's been a great learning experience, I think, both sides.
In these 2 days, what have you learned about LeBron James that you didn't know about him as a competitor?
You know, that's tough in 2 days. Like, this man's whole life's been on a movie for the last 21 years. Right. So it's, you know, it's day to day, you know what I mean? But obviously he's a hell of a competitor, a hell of a leader, hell of a player, one of the best in this game ever. So I'm excited to continue to play alongside him and learn from him.
Jackson Hayes told us about playing in New Orleans, being there after AD was there, and like AD was still, someone was talked about in the organization, he was still clips of examples of how to play like him. I'm wondering, your time in Miami, did you still see the footprints or the thumbprints of LeBron? Like, were there still anecdotes shared by coaching staff members, front office members, and what kind of, you know, lasting impact did you see that he's still in Miami?
I mean, the banners that hang up in the gym, I think that's probably the biggest thing that impact-wise, but obviously there's some stories of his time there and kind of how he conducted himself and so forth. So obviously his legacy is gone, it's part of his legacy, so I'll forever be a part of my own as well.
This is all very new, but what has struck you the most about AD's and LeBron's chemistry and the way they coexist?
Yeah, I think a lot of it that struck me is how organic it is, you know, seeing them off the court, not just in this space, but in multiple spaces now. See how organic and true their relationship is. I think a lot of times you see a lot of quote unquote fake dynamics or relationships that kind of just make a show for y'all. But I think it's organic and genuine, and that's something I appreciate.
How much, if at all, has your senior role kind of changed since you take what you're passing here for?
2 days, yeah.
Oh, yeah, or just, yeah.
But, I mean, I don't think much at all. It's just, you know, we just take a beat and trying to figure out what's what. As far as I'm concerned, nobody really knows their role yet. You know what I mean? Depth charts and games are going to be played and kind of fall in line with what we're kind of looking to do this year. And, so we're kind of playing it all by feel here.
Darvin mentioned that his biggest emphasis or advice for Jalen is just to be more vocal. As a guard yourself, you know, when you were first coming to the league, just what's that challenge like when you're trying to be more vocal, especially on a team when you know others, you know, with stars on it?
Yeah, I mean, it's tough. I think when you're a young player coming to the league and you're being told to tell LeBron James where to go on the court sometimes, like that could be a lot for someone to take on. But You know, if he could do it here, he'll be able to do it in 18 minutes of league. So he's shown a lot of growth in it. It's only day two. He's shown growth in it from yesterday to today. So excited to see his growth throughout the season. I think he's got a hell of an opportunity.
Is that something that you had to go through when you first got into the league, and or advice that you got at any point?
I mean, I was told to be vocal when I was very young, so I have no problem my voice being heard. Almost to a fault sometimes.
This is your second day as a Laker, but I saw you taking the bat role with Jalen. He mentioned that he's been around you a lot too. What are some things that you've been, you know, helping him with, and what are some things you've seen, you know, from him growth-wise in just a short amount of 2 days?
Yeah, I mean, well, all the guys that I've been around that, or I've seen be around, they do the same things every day essentially as part of their lifestyle. So my stuff with him has just kind of been like, what's your routine? And how can we be consistent with it? Or let's get these shots. And an extra 5, 10 minutes of work is not going to do it. We can kind of be smart about it and grow and just continue to prepare yourself and kind of just letting them know how it was for me when I was his age in this league, or when I was young in this league. Every night is different. To kind of mentally prepare yourself for that, because I think that's what breaks a lot of guys in this league early as well. So just kind of just in his ear a little bit, and just trying to be there for him anywhere I can.
Gabe, some guys that have gotten all the way to the finals and not gotten over the hump, talk about the next year and just the kind of the unique way that you understand motivation in basketball in the NBA. Just wondered how it hits you as you now get into this season, having kind of been to the actual finals and noticed the difference between that, even in the conference finals.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard. I think you just realize how difficult it is to win. And so there's little things that you no longer take lightly, because you understand that, okay, in 8 months I'm going to need this. So you have a different attention to detail, I think, a different overall big picture. Some things you thought mattered a lot really don't matter as much. You just try to really continue to build towards one common goal every day.
And just with LeBron and AD specifically, like having been there, you know, for LeBron obviously multiple times, is there something that you get as a player that somebody else that's been there that like that same kind of attention to detail?
I mean, well, there's 1,000 ways to cook chicken. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I don't think there's just one way to do it. His way is obviously proven 10 trips, you know what I mean? So the proof's in the pudding for him. So just kind of trying to learn his system and the way he operates in his day-to-day and go from there.
How's it been for you? First day, like, not being with the Heat anymore, you're with the Lakers, you're from Stockton, so not far, and you played at UC Santa Barbara. How does it feel like being with the Lakers show, first day, you know, up until now?
Yeah, no, it's fun. Obviously, it's great being back out west, going to school in Santa Barbara. I got a lot of people out here, so in some regard, it feels like I'm just turned back the hands of time, you know, and kind of restarted here, so it's been fun. I've obviously learned something a little bit new here, the way they do things, but it's been fun to compete and get to know the guys as well.
Thanks, everybody.